KubeCon Europe 2023 is just behind the corner, and it's full with a lot of great talks and great speakers. But a lot of people really getting swamped or confused by the number of talks, and they don't know which talks are worth to watch live and the other that they can watch after on YouTube. This is why in this video I'm trying to help you with the FOMO and help you to find out the talks that are worth watching live at the event. So those are my 8 talks that are must watch during KubeCon Europe. Let's go. Before we are starting, it's worth mentioning that there are a lot of great talks in this KubeCon, and it seems like 3 days are just not enough to get into all of them. So I recommend my best 8, but definitely there are many talks which worth getting and watch. For any talk that I'm going to recommend during this video, you can find the link in the description below. That's great. Let's start with the first one. What is the most complex part in Kubernetes infrastructure? Networking. And what happens when you mix Kubernetes, virtual networking, and external networking components? Yes, you get a spaghetti. And this is why learning from the top chefs in the industry can make you very strong and experts at networking. This is why the experts Marino and Jason created this hands-on tutorial to let you deep dive into Kubernetes networking. In the talk, Measure Twice, Cut Once, Dive into Network Foundation the Right Way, they're going to make a tutorial which is going to involve Core DNS, Istio, Envoy, CNI, and Cilium, and other networking tools to let everyone to actually practice and learn more about those projects. And what's very interesting that it's a tutorial talk, there are not many of them, and learning from them going to make you much better in Kubernetes networking. The second talk that you must go to in KubeCon EU is about the third most active CNCF project in 2022. And yes, it's Backstage. Backstage is the most popular. And Ben and Patrick, which are the maintainers of Backstage, are going to talk about the state of Backstage in 2023. It means that they are going to break out 2022. They are going to talk about the challenges, the recent features, and what's planned for 2023. Keep in mind that KubeCon is all about sharing knowledge and talking with maintainers. This talk is a talk from the maintainers track. It means that you can meet face to face and listen to maintainers in this talk. It is very recommended to go at least to one of the talks that are from maintainers. If a good use case and a good story from a big company really makes you goosebumps, I always like to learn and hear stories from people that actually did hands-on job, did a big project, and they are going to share their story. And I guess any one of you know Adobe, which is a very big company doing creator tools. And in this talk called Tip from the Trenches, GitOps at Adobe by Larissa and Lonat Maxim, they are going to share their story of how they are migrated from Spinnaker to Argo CD and created this GitOps methodology at Adobe. They're going to talk about the challenges, the project they are doing the way, from a technical perspective, but also from a non-technical perspective. If you are working in a smaller company than Adobe, understanding what are the challenges when you are moving to a larger scale can be very valuable. So they are going to share all the story about this migration and how they moved into GitOps. Our fourth talk is about ephemeral clusters. Ephemeral clusters allow you to, first of all, reduce cost in staging and development environment. And second of all, it basically allow you to increase the development velocity. In any discussion I have with enterprise company, ephemeral clusters are coming into place. And in this talk, ephemeral clusters as a service with cluster API and GitOps, Joaquin and Alessandro are going to break down how you can create your own ephemeral clusters using Argo CD, Cluster API, and Thanos. I would say that both of them are subject experts in the area. And fun fact is Alessandro is one of the KubeCon committee member and also is one of the community leaders in Amsterdam. So I would say that maybe this KubeCon could not happen without him. For the fifth talk, you got a unique opportunity to see Liz Rice and Kelsey Hightower on the same stage. And they are going to be joined by other great people like Guillermo from Vercel, Shang Liang from Acron, and Tom from Vim. And they are not going to talk about only technology. They are going to talk about business. And building a successful business in cloud native is a tough thing to do. But it really helps you, even in your if you're not planning to build a business in cloud native. Why? Because it will help you to understand what are the trends in the ecosystem, which tools from companies it's better to pick and which one you should avoid. And if you would learn a little bit about the business in the ecosystem, you will be able to do a good decision that will take your team to a better way. So you would say it's a gold talk. And if you don't want to miss the gold talks in this KubeCon, this is a must talk to go to, even though it's not a very geeky, techy one talk. Before we are talking about the sixth talk, I want to talk a little bit about the future of the CNCF in the community. And if you think about it, any kind of community need to invest and build by young people getting in and putting a lot of effort to make the community great. And if you want to build a sustainable community, you need to invest a lot of resources in students. Mark and Kunal from Civo actually doing a lot of community work with CNCF students and programs in this area. So in their talk called Building the Framework of the Future with CNCF Student, you will get to know better about student programs, what is the future and what are the challenges with student programs in the CNCF. So it's a very recommended tool for everyone thinking about the future, for everyone who wants to contribute into CNCF programs, student programs in the community. So for the seventh talk, I would like to recommend something a little bit about stateful workloads. Why? Like, stateful workloads on Kubernetes is a big thing. Like, we all a little bit want to run them, but on the other side, we're a little bit afraid of them. PostgreSQL is a very popular database and very known in the industry. So this is why Karen from Crunchy is going to talk about mission-critical Postgres databases on Kubernetes and allow you to learn a little bit about stateful workloads. So either if you are running stateful workloads on Kubernetes, you are planning to run stateful workloads on Kubernetes, it seems like it's a great talk to get a lot of knowledge about Postgres on Kubernetes. So the last talk that it's a must watch in this KubeCon is about load balancers in Kubernetes. And load balancers in Kubernetes can be a good thing because it's automatically orchestrated, but it can be a big problem. If you want to learn about load balancer reliability, there is no better company to learn from than Confluent. Confluent actually runs the biggest Kafka managed service worldwide. And if you're running Kafka managed clusters or you manage it on your own, on your clusters, you might heard about Confluent and you understand that running in a big scale as them, everything matters. And load balancer can be a pain point in any cluster. So I would recommend to go to this talk to learn from Confluent about reliability of this load balancer. These are the 8 talks that I recommend to watch during this KubeCon. I would say that there are many, many great talks out there, and each pick that you would do would be good. If you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel.